Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great Outlook tip for you today that has to do with a contact group or a distribution list, as it used to be called, and scheduling meetings with your calendar. This video will have chapters or bookmarks down below because I'm going to start off creating a contact group, and then I'm going to use the contact group with my calendar trick. So if you already know how to do a contact group, go ahead and skip over to the calendar trick. Let's dive in right now. Outlook desktop is running. I'm going to go over to the people icon. If your people icon is not up here in the top left, I'm running a preview of the new version of Outlook. This is the only item that's different. Your people icon is in the bottom left corner. There are my contacts right here. Christian, Robert, Carol, and Carol Wilson, and Carol Martin. I'm going to create a new contact group, formerly known as a distribution list. Select new contact group. Give it a name. I'm going to call it coworkers. That's the name of it. Who do you want to be in it? Add members. I'm going to go from my address book, which is your work distribution list, but you could also pull in people that are Outlook contacts, people outside your company, university, organization. You could also just type in emails. If you're interested in pulling in an Excel file, I have a video up in the top right corner of how to pull in an Excel file and make a contact group. But I'm going to go from address book. This is internal for me. There is Carol Wilson. Click on members. I'm also going to add Christian. Click on members. Click OK. So I've got two people in my contact group called coworkers. Save and close. So now in my people, I have coworkers. Just a little easy tip for you. If you come up here to business cards, because I'm on people, Christian, Robert, Carol, Carol. If you notice this little gray bar running up and down, whenever you have a contact group, it actually will say the word group, and it's just a little wider. No big deal. I'm just pointing that out. If you want to email these, just click and drag them over to your email. I know it says coworkers on the to line, and it should, but when they get the email, it will not say coworkers. They will all see it broken out. So if you want to see it yourself, you hit the plus symbol and you hit OK. This is how the email is going to go out. What's cool about this little trick about hitting the plus symbol, if I didn't want Carol to get the email for some reason, even though she's a member of the group, I can just take her off right here. I'm not sending this. I'm going to close it. Before I close it, one quick tip. If your contact group is people outside your company, let's say that you deal in the purchasing department and you have a contact group for vendors. And those vendors are from different companies, and those people do not know each other. Make sure coworkers, so I just typed it here, make sure that that contact group goes on the blind carbon copy line in your email. That way, when they get the email, they don't know who else got the email. Also, if they do a reply to all, only you will get the email. Really important point for people outside your company. Options, there is BCC right there, by the way, in case you're wondering how in the world did I get BCC, blind carbon copy. Okay, sorry, I got to cover everything, so now it's time for my cool trick. So now I'm going to go to my calendar. I need to schedule a meeting with the people that are in a contact group. I'm going to pick, let's go to today, and let's just move ahead to next week. I'm going to go to Monday the 6th and right click. This is a new meeting request because an appointment is just for you. When the new meeting request pops up, I like to go to the scheduling assistant myself. I do have required and optional here, but I like to go to the scheduling assistant to make sure these people are available. And here's the tip. Co-workers. I click there were 15 people in my contact group. Expand it. Hit OK. So now I'm looking at all 15 people without having to type in those 15 names. How about that trick? So I can see basically that, by the way, that Carol looks busy between when I'm trying to schedule this meeting. So I can go and make it on another day. I don't care. Here we go, 9 o'clock. There it is up there. You could send it off, but I always go back to meeting. Make sure you have a meeting title and make sure it's a very descriptive title. Then it do Teams meeting, whatever you want to do from here. So I took a contact group, we created it, but I'm using that contact group to quickly schedule meetings. Last note, if going back to the vendor contact group list, there is no need to go to the scheduling assistant because you can't view their availability. They don't work at your university, company, organization. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell. Let me know if you like this video. Any comments are appreciated. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.